State Capitol political firestorm surrounding State Senator Nicole Mitchell. The Democrat from Woodbury is charged with breaking into her stepmother's home in Detroit Lakes. And while she denies the charge, Capitol Republicans are calling for her to resign immediately. Today, Senate Republicans filed an ethics complaint against Mitchell and tried to put that on the fast track.
John Croman joins us live from the Capitol with a recap of what happened today. John?
Hey, you know, normally the ethics subcommittee has 30 days to act on a complaint. This complaint arrived today, so in theory, they wouldn't get to that until like the end of session or after session, actually. So what Senate Republicans were trying to do today was kind of put that on the fast track and force an early vote, an early action by the subcommittee to try to get this thing going sooner.
I am the only person in this body that has a long-time history being an election judge.
That was Nicole Mitchell last Thursday on the Senate floor. Since then, the Woodbury Democrat has been arrested and charged with first-degree burglary for breaking into her stepmother's house. And on this day, her Senate seat sat empty as Republicans called for her permanent ouster.
To consider expelling Senator Nicole Mitchell from the Minnesota Senate.
Senator Eric Lucero is one of those who filed a formal ethics complaint against Mitchell, seeking her expulsion from the Senate. He made a motion on the Senate floor to fast-track the process by forcing the ethics subcommittee to take up Mitchell's case immediately.
According to the criminal complaint, after being Mirandized, Senator Nicole Mitchell made the comment, quote, "I know I did something bad."
Senate Democrats argued instead for the traditional process, giving the ethics panel up to 30 days to respond to the complaint.
We have an ethics complaint process in our rules. It's there for a reason.
Members, please vote.
The Senate deadlocked 33-33 along straight party lines, so the motion failed. Mitchell didn't take part in the vote. And while she's taken to Facebook to say she was only checking on the welfare of a family member, her arrest has sent shockwaves through the Capitol.
Senator Mitchell is a duly elected member of the Senate, and she's elected to represent the interests of the people who sent her here. I anticipate that she is going to participate until she can't anymore.
Already today and tomorrow, Senator Mitchell is having an impact on the business of the Minnesota Senate. We no longer have bills on the floor today or tomorrow, and committees are being canceled. So we need to get this resolved ASAP.
And it is actually true what the Senator Johnson said. They had three bills on the Senate calendar today. Those were all scrubbed. Those were cleared off. And it's not known if it's just because of all of the tension around Mitchell's arrest or if it's because the Democrats needed all 34 votes to pass that. And without her, they couldn't pass any of those bills. We did check with the ethics. The Senate Research Library, and they told us that no senators have ever been expelled in the history of the Senate. As far as Nicole Mitchell, her attorneys issued a statement today reminding people that a criminal complaint is not the same as a conviction. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, John.